Oke, okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kita biasanya kita akan mulakan dengan umur kitab lah, Al-Fatihah. Oke, okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Kalau saya duduk ke nak saya bangun? Kalau rasa nak tidur dah saya bangun lah. Ya, tak tidur. Ya. Alright. So saya Suhailah bin Syafi'i. Akan menyampaikan TOT berkaitan dengan realiti terimbuh. Kalau dalam bahasa Inggeris dia, berapa? Virtual reality ke augmented reality? Nak test ni. Orang-orang bernama. Okay, ada dua lah kalau kita sebut reality ni yang famous ada dua iaitu augmented, satu lagi virtual reality. Virtual dengan augmented. So yang terimbun ni adalah virtual reality. Ya. Cuma kita akan tengok bagaimana augmented reality ni kita boleh apply ataupun kita boleh guna dalam konteks media dan kewartawanan. Lah. So ini agenda kita. Slide saya ni memang semua video. Okay. Sebab saya pun beritahu last minute. Dan AR ni bukan bidang saya sebenarnya. So, bidang saya more on clustering dan juga programming lah. Tapi apa yang saya akan explain hari ni adalah semua orang boleh buat AR. Jadi tak perlu jadi expert lah untuk talk pasal AR ni. Okay, so perkenalan tentang saya. Kemudian kita akan masuk tentang isu sedikit. Isu ni sesi brainstorming sikit lah ataupun ice breaking ya. Kemudian ada perkongsian tentang AR, apa itu AR, macam mana AR tu, jenis-jenis dia, alat-alat dia dan aplikasi dia. Dan mungkin kita ada rehat sekejap, lepas tu ada sesi hands on, kita buat AR sendiri menggunakan Zappa. Zappa tu perisian untuk membolehkan kita buat AR lah. Alright. Okay, perkenalan tentang saya, saya pernah mengajar di UTM, di UTP dan juga last kali di UNIZA lah. Sekarang pun masih lagi di UNIZA. Antara subjek yang saya mengajar adalah programming lah. Basically semua subjek saya adalah programming dan database semua tu. Dan ada juga saya pernah mengajar computer graphic. On penyelidikan saya more on clustering, ni PhD saya, saya buat on K-means clustering dan AHP. Dan kebanyakan produk-produk research saya more on untuk membantu pelajar belajar lah. Dia more on e-learning. Contohnya kalau buat programming, dia nak tahu bila dia compile ada error, tu so kita nak bagi feedback apakah error-error dia tu. Satu more on kalau dia berminat lah nak buat PhD, saya lebih suka ke arah tu lah. Sebelum saya join sebagai pensyarah di UNIZA ni, saya adalah programmer juga lah ataupun bekerja di software house. Antara projek-projek saya banyaklah banyakkannya web. Tentu adalah antara klien-klien kita, Share, Petronas. Malakoff ni waktu saya di UNIZA pun saya masih lagi ada buat sistem untuk Malakoff terutamanya berkaitan dengan e-learning. Dan di UNIZA sendiri pun walaupun saya adalah pensyarah bukannya orang IT, bukannya pusat IT, saya pun turut membantu membangunkan sistem-sistem untuk kegunaan pensyarah, pelajar dan juga staff lah. Itu antara sistem-sistem yang saya develop lah. Dan juga untuk IPG pun ada juga buat sistem. Okay, sebelum kita start, kita ice breaking sikit. Contohnya ada gambar macam ni. Sebab ni pemberita lah. Dia biasa menggunakan gambar lah untuk sebagai main point dia. So, saya nak tengok sedikit bagaimana kita semua yang ada dalam ni. Apakah tajuk yang kita rasa sesuai untuk gambar tu? Kalau kita sebagai pemberita ke, pesyarah ke, nak tengok macam mana pandangan kita kan? So boleh scan tu, Mentimeter. Boleh scan Mentimeter. Scan QR code tu. Kemudian masukkan tajuk gambar ni. Tajuk bagi gambar ni. Ataupun gambar ni kena reject kalau nak masuk paper ni. Andaikan lah. Masukkan tajuk ya. Okay, saya buka sikit yang ni. Kosong respon. Dia sepatut ada at least 7 daripada bernama, 3 daripada Yuniza. Tak cukup ni, tak boleh balik. Kita pun dia sakut di sini lah. Okay, panda depan pun. Simple je tajuk ni. Panda depan. Okay. Nama ni. Kalau ada respon je, dia masuk kat situ lah. Soalan, kena klik submit lah. Submit. Okay, jangan pandang belakang. Dia biasa akan mempengaruhi lah. Dah tengok tajuk ni, mempengaruhi. Okay, jangan ganggu saya. Ha, ni macam berita ni. Right. Artis SSF tu maksud ni macam dia tak kenal siapa tu. Siapa dua orang ni. Okay, lagi masa sikit, 5 minit lagi. Okay, kita takkan publish apa berita ni. Saja dalam ni je. Okay. Gambar sebagai hiasan tu kot. Lambar yang ditolak tu. Right. So, ini sebenarnya menguji kita punya kreativiti lah, kreativiti, dan sebenarnya kreativiti kita tu dia didokong ataupun di berasaskan knowledge kita lah dan juga budaya kita. Kalau kita dah budaya macam tu, kita akan jatuh lah. Okay, seorang lagi, saya tunggu seorang lagi. 7. Sebab sekian. Okay. Alright. Memang tajuk lepas ni tak ada orang lain lah. Okay. Dan isu ni sebenarnya berkait dengan kita. Berkait dengan kita hari ini. Kita selepas ni. Bila kita sebut konteks, dia mungkin berbeza sikit. Perbalahan dramatik di tempat awam. Okay. Alright, 7 lah. Hold up. Alright. Alright. So, tak ada apa. Ini just untuk suka-suka je. Tak ada apa pun. Ada lagi ke? Okay, so, sebenarnya bila kita buat satu gambar, dia akan memberi kita satu ekspresi yang setiap orang tak sama. So, itulah cabaran dalam berita ni. Kita kalau based on gambar saja sebenarnya tak cukup sebenarnya untuk kita memberikan berita tu lah. Tapi memang kalau dalam surat gambar tu, gambar je lah. Teks pun tak ada banyak. Jadi limited. Jadi sebab tu kita perlukan satu teknologi baru lah. Teknologi yang boleh menampung kelemahan berita kita. Sebab kita tak boleh letak semua berita dalam tu. Ataupun semua perincian. Jadi kena ada satu cara, alternatif lain yang boleh kita gunakan untuk mengatasi isu-isu berkaitan dengan berita yang kurang perincian ya. Okey, habis di sini ya. Baik. Okay. So, sebenarnya ini adalah berkait dengan isu kesihatan. Okey. Kesihatan sebenarnya. Dua orang ni adalah pakar kesihatan lah. Yang ni tukar urut orang. Yang ni farmasi Chow ke apa nama dia, saya tak ingat. Dia farmasi. Tengoklah video dia.
Bahu, belakang dan leher. Aksi pertama, tangan ke tangan. Buka tangan dan tengok ke atas. Aksi kedua, satu tangan letak di pinggang dan satu tangan pegang kepala. Pusing belakang dan tengok ke langit. Aksi ketiga, tangan letak di pinggang, kepit macam ini. Tempat ini kalau sumbat, badan selalu letih. Saya ajar buat 3 aksi untuk kuatkan bahu, belakang dan leher. Aksi pertama, tangan ke tangan. Buka tangan dan tengok ke atas. Aksi kedua, satu tangan letak di pinggang dan satu tangan pegang kepala, pusing belakang dan tengok ke langit. Aksi ketiga, tangan letak di pinggang, kepit macam ini.
Okey. Aksi keempat kita buat sama-sama. Okey, sebab dia memang kita berada dalam bengkel, kita mata kita kalau kita guna laptop, kita akan ke bawah lah kepala kita kan. Jadi memang akan letih. Ini bila letih tu buatlah kita punya exercise ni. So yang pertama dia kata apa ni, longgar kepala ke atas dan buat macam ni, tepuk macam ni. Biar dia rasa lah belakang lah. Dia bukan nak tepuk saja ni, ni nak biar rasa belakang ni. Wah, rasa. Okay, itu yang pertama. Yang kedua, tangan kita ni letak belakang kepala. Ada habis lah, belakang kepala. Yang belakang ni letak belakang pinggang dan pandang ke atas. Rasa belakang tu. Sekali. Tukar, tangan ni belakang, tangan ni duduk di atas kepala. Tengok ke atas. Sama lagi sebab tak habis. Ada satu lagi. Okay, so kita buat macam ni di belakang. Dan ni, ni punya ni. Bagikan kita punya ni. Jelas ke belakang. Kita tak boleh rata, lengkap. Itu salah satu cara dia. So, sebagai programmer, memang kita kena buatlah benda ni. Dan saya pun kalau saya buat coding, memang saya akan buatlah. Tak susah pun kita tengah buat-buat, rasa lengah sikit, terus buat. Yang ni pula apa pula? Chris Leong ni.
在推个上去，你一推咗呢个手入上去，嗱，你个头已经系平行咗，呢个平行。咁你做得乜嘢？你试下同头先嗰只转头咁左右弹，而家你顶住咗啫。咁你转头咧，你会感觉到你都系咁样转咧，咁我都唔使落。再转一边，嗱，你听到两边耳仔呢度系咪？好似你推到最高，你开始转，你系变成咁样啦，好似咬咗咬咁。
不断
咯，啪一声。哦，咔一声，嚟听到啪啪两声，呢个啪一两声嚟讲咧，咦，呢个地多五分钟到十分钟，咦，感觉到松啲嘅喎，系喎，好似听。
有少少松咗咯。
系啊，呢个状态因为颈椎，我哋嘅颈椎日日都要碌望全体，日日电脑啊，手平板手机咁样，咁咧耐咗咧，系由撇脱咗，咁我哋点样咧？系呢个推翻起个平线位，再一转咧，佢就开翻后颈，挫翻正嘅啫，一左一右就得啦。
Ini
dia
tengok selepas ni. Baik. So kalau kita pre berita ni habis lah kat situ kan, dah orang buat spekulasi. So tadi tak ada cara nak tengok ibu ni kan. Jadi itulah guna AR. Kita tengok bagaimana AR boleh memberikan walaupun satu gambar je, dia boleh memberikan gambar berita yang lebih tepat dan lebih terperinci. Right. Next. Okay, so apa itu reality terimbuh? Bahasa Melayunya reality terimbuh. Bahasa Inggeris dia augmented, augmented reality. Augmented tu maksud dia make something greater by adding to it ataupun increase. Menjadikan dia lebih baik lah. So dalam bahasa Melayu dia imbuh. Itu menambah. Imbuhan kan? Imbuhan kan? Katanya kita tambah. So tu dah dipanggil datanya imbuh tu. Tu imbuh tu saya ambil daripada PPRM, DBP dalam bahasa dan augment tu daripada kamus Oxford. Sebab tu nama dia reality terimbuh. Okay, dia ada reality dan kita tambah pada reality tu. So, apa beza augmented reality dengan virtual reality? Dia sebenarnya reality tu adalah reality kan, tapi sebenarnya bila masuk IT ni reality tu dia subjektif pula, ada reality yang betul, ada reality yang tidak betul. Maka kita faham reality reality lah, tapi dalam IT ni reality yang betul, reality yang tak betul. So reality yang tidak betul kita panggil reality buatan. So augmented virtual tu dia adalah reality yang bukan betul-betul reality lah, dia adalah buatan. Contoh kalau bilik ni saya lukis gambar. Gambar tu adalah buatan. Lukis gambar bilik ni kan. Dia bukan bilik tapi dia gambar. Itulah virtual. Tapi dalam konteks digital lah. Augmented ni, dia realiti sebenar. Bilik ni. Bilik ni. Cuma kita tambah je. Ada meja situ, nak ada apa almari ke situ. Ha. Tapi menggunakan persekitaran sebenar. Cuma kita tambah je. Terbezir ya. Macam ni. So, ni realiti ni macam ni lah. Dekat studio. Kan dia ada green screen, dah ada orang. Tapi apa yang dia buat augmented, dia tambah dengan ni. Dengan realiti yang tidak sebenar ni. Ni augmented lah. So dia tambah. Boleh ya? Augmented, simple je. Okay, kemudian kita tengok jenis-jenis AR. Dia ada beberapa jenis AR ni. So supaya kita nanti kita ada hands on. Kita tahulah beza dia. So basically ada dua beza yang utama, iaitu marker based dan markerless based. Okay, yang ada marker dan tidak ada marker. So kita tengok sikit bagaimana AR yang marker based ni.
Examples of ZapWorks in action. So this is a human bioscience lab manual which we've augmented here with some content. So we're scanning the code and the video pops up, which explains that diagram. It's just some content pulled off YouTube. You can see the video is actually tracking to the image on the page. You can pop that image out and go full screen if you like. We just reset that and we're scanning the code for this. This is electrical pulses through the heart. So we have a 2D diagram there and we can fire up. So this is a screen capture from a virtual reality application. So we've got a nice animation here which demonstrates that to us. It's just a larger scale multicolored illustration. This is something a bit different. So we've got a solar system on the page there and a code. And we're using the image on the page there to track the augmented content. So the augmented content, we use that image of the solar system as almost like a placemat which it sits on. So that will stay still and you will be able to move around the solar system. And the content here, if you tap it, is interactive. It gives you some information. That's not one we've created. This has come from ZapWorks.
Right. Okay, so itulah AR. So apa yang di augment, sama ada video, kita tengok tadi ada video tentang jantung ataupun 3D model. Ni 3D model. So dia enhancekan ataupun dia tambah dengan 3D model. Yang ada sekitaran sebenar dia, realiti dia hanya satu kertas saja. Itu dia tambah. Sama ada video, teks pun, dia boleh buat link macam-macam lah, dia boleh buat. Itu AR. Tapi dia perlukan marker, dia perlukan tempat yang kita kena scan baru dia keluar benda tu. The marker base. So, dalam konteks macam gambar tadi tu, gambar Chris Leong tu. So kalau kita buat AR, dia scan, keluar video tentang tu. So tak perlu rasa nak spekulasi lah. Right, next lah, ni satu jenis. Pani ada quiz ni. tak ada quiz. Alright, so next adalah markerless lah. Ha, ni markerless. Apa beza dia? Marker base dengan markerless. Dia tak perlu scan apa-apa. Dia ambil gambar je, terus keluar objek tu kan. Tu tak ada marker lah. Tadi dia kena scan QR code ke apa kan. Ni markerless. Benda ni kita akan buat nanti. Dua-dua ni, markerless dengan markerpiece. Contohnya kat sini, kita ambil gambar kat sini, kita nak ada benda kat situ. Satu lagi kita nak, contohnya kita ambil muka kita, kalau orang scan muka kita, keluar benda tu. Itu marker. Kita tengok jenis seterusnya. Ni basic lah. Maksudnya kalau orang tanya apa itu AR, dua ni lah yang kena ingat. Ini yang basic dia. Itu marker base dan markerless. So advance lagi. Ada projection lah. Itu projection. Beza dia adalah dia apa tu? Tadi kita nampak dekat handset kan. Ni maksudnya dia nampak di persekitaran tu, di project ke dinding ke lantai, pada atap semua tu. Itu projection. Maksudnya kena ada projector lah untuk buat ni. Okay, tapi dia adalah dia tambahkan elemen grafik, video dan dia ada interactivity juga kat situ kan. AR tu. So, ini jenis AR projection. Ini kalau nak buat ni kena bayar RM500,000 lah. Kita buat APK tu. yang kita buat petang ni, lepas ni, free je. Dan ni nak buat, kena panggil pakar lah. Saya pun tak kerti ni. Okay, nice. Ini super impose lah. Super impose.
Construction sites going digital and potentially saving taxpayers a whole lot of money. ABC 15's Sonu Wasu taking us inside a brand new school in one of the fastest growing communities in the East Valley, showing us how virtual reality is bringing this project to life.
There'll be a grandstand bleacher.
Cole Woodward, a project manager for Core Construction, has given a lot of tours. He loves showing off his latest project, the brand new Eastmark High School being built right on the border of Mesa and Queen Creek.
It's going to be a beautiful school.
Hard to tell if you just look at these blueprints on paper. Now, apparently, the old-fashioned way, because Woodward says the future lies in these QR codes. You'll find them scattered all over this hard hat zone.
We have 14 of these set up all over the site.
A quick scan on your smartphone and it's time to bring this project to life using virtual reality goggles. It gave me a whole new perspective.
I like the landscaping.
Of the entrance. Without goggles, all we see is dirt and steel beams. Through the virtual reality lens, this is the entrance of Eastmark High, home of the Firebirds. Inside the framework, construction workers are still hammering away, building the cafeteria, the gymnasium, and classrooms. The virtual reality goggles giving us a sneak peek into the future as the rooms come to life. All that's missing here now, the students.
Is this the future of construction? I believe so.
The project manager tells us they're doing this not for the cool factor, but because it's a lot more efficient.
We consistently deliver our projects on time and under budget.
These virtual reality goggles have replaced this. Pages and pages of blueprints showing you what the school would look like. Less time, less paper, and under budget. All good news for taxpayers. From the school's perspective,
the really important part for us is that on day one, when we move into the school, it's what we want and what we need for our students.
Jim Lamb with the Queen Creek School District has overseen the construction of many schools in the valley. He says so often school officials will decide the layout just doesn't work after the walls go up. This can lead to very costly delays on taxpayer dime. Eastmark High School is set to open in July. In Mesa, Sonu Wasu, ABC 15, Arizona.
On the run, no more.
So, lebih kurang juga ya projection tu, cuma dia tukar kita punya environment tu. Dia bagi superimpose lah, dia tukar environment tu. Kalau macam tadi, benda ni nampak unduh je, tak nampak apa-apa kan. Dia di superimpose, dia tukar kepada environment yang sebenarnya. Itu superimpose lah. Lebih kurang juga yang projection tadi. Cuma projection tu dia nampak di dinding. Eh. Ni dia nampak di sini lah. Right. Next.
Construction sites going digital.
Ini outlining ya, ni AR yang terakhir. Ada apa AR ni? Lima. Okay. Nah, ini AR yang terakhir dia. Ini outlining ya.
Visiting a hospital can often be an anxiety-inducing ordeal, especially when you don't have a clear idea of where you're going and feel the added stress of being late for your appointment. What if I tell you there's a better option? ARway developed an innovative augmented reality wayfinding solution that completely transforms the hospital experience. By simply scanning a QR code with your smartphone, you can activate an AR path and on-screen step-by-step directions to navigate absolutely anywhere in the hospital with ease. Using AR navigation is 2 times faster than using traditional 2D navigation with physical signage. This means less time spent searching for appointments and more time spent receiving care. Best news for hospitals? This solution requires no Wi-Fi, no beacons, and no hardware.
Itu outline, dia letak line lah. Okay, dan ni biasa guna juga dekat kereta, kereta yang autopilot lah. Alright, so tu jenis-jenis AR yang ada. Benda kita tengok alat-alat pula, alat-alat AR. Okay, alat-alat AR pula. Tadi jenis-jenis AR. So, ni jenis-jenis alat yang kita boleh guna lah. Kita fokus pada, macam tadi kita tengok hanya handset lah. Tengok headset kan. So ni tengok alat yang pertama, headset ataupun smart glass yang dipakai di kepala ataupun di mata lah.
Shared experience in AR is really important and I am excited to see the technology growing to support this.
This see-through display where you can still see everything around you, but then you have this like extremely crisp visual on top.
My favorite feature is that you can see the other people's eyes when they're wearing them, and that's much more natural than something that covers your face.
It feels like I'm looking through regular glasses.
AR can sometimes feel very isolating, so knowing that there can be a social aspect to that is a really cool feature I'm excited to explore.
The mobile application that comes with the device has spectator capabilities that someone else can see exactly what you're doing.
The fact that we could build a connected experience where two people are both, you know, having that shared AR vision happening in front of them, but also being able to see the other person creates all these interesting play moments that you can't get with a lot of other things. I love the shareability factor, the fact just, oh, here's a pair of glasses, put these on, be able to experience kind of the stuff that we've built, and that's huge for adoption for this kind of stuff.
We see connected lenses as one of the core elements of the device. We are learning a lot about how people interact between each other with a technology, kind of like a canvas in between.
Connected lenses are really exciting to me because it does make everything a group activity. The lack of a tether, so it being self-contained and being able to move around, you know, in 3D, interact with other people in real time.
You'd see devices that really just constrain you to your living room, even to your couch. Spectacles actually get you out of your seat, outside, out the door, and out into the real world, where you're going to be going to new places, meeting new people.
So I'm really excited to use the spectacles to, you know, enhance people's real world experiences.
My main hope for working on AR projects is that the things I can do help people grow their understanding of the world and each other. It's going to benefit people all over the place, and Snap is doing a tremendous job of making this technology accessible.
So tengok tu spectacles ni dia dah jual, memang kita boleh beli buat. So apa dia buat ni, dia macam spek mata biasa, kita pakai tu kita nampak lah depan ni. Tapi kita juga nampak apa yang ada dekat skrin di spek mata kita tu, AR tu. Ada banyaklah produk-produk macam ni, dan FIQ sendiri pun ada satu ada lah benda ni. Kalau nak try, nak feel, boleh pergi ke besok lah pula sempat ni. Okay, so tu alat pertama, dia ada headset. Headset ni, ni smart glass. Dia ada headset tu yang pakai satu kepala lah. Tapi sama lah konsep dia. Okay, alat yang kedua untuk AR ni.
Shared experience in AR is...
contact lens. Tak nampak boleh pakai spek.
Modern technology promises to keep us more connected. But in surrounding ourselves with screens and devices, it feels as though we've lost something. Imagine if we could replace our screens with something that informs without distraction. Could we see differently, more clearly? Could it help us find that invisible edge when we need it most? Or allow us to connect in crucial moments, providing vital information in an instant? Introducing Mojo Lens, the world's first augmented reality smart contact lens. Put Mojo Lens on in the morning, and throughout your day, you'll have access to timely information without losing focus on the world around you. Mojo Lens is designed not to bombard you with data, but to elevate your vision by providing the information you need exactly when it's needed, all while letting you look like yourself. When it's not in use, the technology just fades away. We call this concept invisible computing.
Mojo's invisible computing solution will be a platform that gives you everyday superpowers and an invisible edge throughout your day. But before it does any of that, it first has to be a great contact lens that improves your natural vision even when it's off. Mojo Lens built-in display will give you augmented reality wherever you look. It even works with your eyes closed, putting you into an instant VR world.
The applications are nearly limitless, from being able to see in the dark or low light situations, to augmenting your memory with instant information, showing you real-time translations, or giving you a virtual teleprompter. One of our first medical applications is using AR overlays like edge detection and contrast enhancements to help people with vision impairments such as glaucoma and macular degeneration.
Building the world's first AR contact lens is a systems engineering problem, and therefore we've had to innovate in many different areas. The Mojo Lens includes thin film, biosafe batteries to power the system, as well as motion sensors to enable the world's most accurate eye tracking. We've also developed an extremely low power image sensor that's used for computer vision and scene detection. But at the heart of the Mojo Lens is the world's smallest and densest dynamic display. With this, we can display crisp text, photos, and video in a package that's less than half a millimeter in diameter. We are often asked, how do you control Mojo Lens? And the answer is with your eyes. It turns out that your eye is an extremely accurate pointing device. With our built-in eye tracking in each lens, we believe we've unlocked the ultimate hands-free user interface.
I like to say, if it doesn't break the laws of physics, then it's possible. And proving that something like Mojo Lens is possible motivates us each and every day to invent the future. Ultimately, we believe that we can help people achieve their potential without sacrificing their humanity. That's the promise of invisible computing. Thank you very much for your time today. Eyes up.
Ha, So nanti kita akan nampak ramai lah orang gila tak dekat jalan. Rangkaian-rangkaian orang tengok. Nanti dia ada mungkin ada VR yang kena sampai berbaik sangka lah. Orang gila ni hebat ni lah. Ada AR. Alright. So next. Seterusnya. Ni tak payah tunjuk lah. Ini handset biasa lah. Macam tadi kita scan guna handset tu. Keluar AR kat headset. Ni projector lah. Yang tadi nampak projector ni alat dia. Dah ada jual pun. Tak silap saya. Tak sampai 1,000 pun.
What is a light?
Ni alat projector boleh search kat Shopee ni. Light Cube. Ni alat terakhir lah yang saya tunjuk, iaitu head up display yang ni digunakan dekat apa tu?
Malam 9 jam dah.
Kalau tak nak beli alat ni pun boleh guna handset. Set ni letak depan kita punya dashboard tu. Dia akan keluar apa yang ada kat skrin ni. So kita kena install lah software dia. Dia keluar lah kat skrin kita tu. Murah je alat ni dalam RM30 je. Maksudnya kereta bezal lagi boleh jadi macam Tesla. Kalau install. Alright, so tu habis tentang AR. Kita masuk sikit intro sikit macam mana kita nak guna AR dalam media ni. Basically benda sama juga ni.
Creative ways to use AR in print media. AR newspapers, from commercials to editorials, combine a variety of interactive features with rich 3D content to connect with your audience in new ways. AR books and magazines. Transform the reading experience of a reader in a unique and interactive manner. AR catalog allows customers to see the products in the environment around them and experiment them. AR business cards. Turn your business cards into an interactive experience to the customers. Restaurant menus. Generate the 3D models of your dishes just by scanning them. Give an extra gear to your print media with DevDen Creative Solutions.
Topik kita hari ini, rasa jelas tak saya? Saya pun selepas tengok video tu baru saya tahu banyak ni. Ya, saya ingat scan itu keluar video. Sebenarnya adalah tajuk kita pada hari ini, revolusi inilah. Ini kita promos sikit lah buku kita, Azwar. Okay, so katakan dapat paper macam ni, nak tengok detail ataupun nak tengok bila berita ni, mungkin tak nampak lagi kat situ kan. Semua tak ada soal apa ni, kita tak tahu. Jadi kalau kita ada buat AR, kena bernama dia buat AR, kita tak perlu scan apa pun, scan gambar tu je. Scan gambar dia keluar detail. Mungkin ada video dia temu ramah, mungkin ada dekat mana nak cari ni, link dia kan, link pasal dia. Ya, apa tak? Tahan ni dia buat. Jangan betah, betah dia layan. So maksudnya, kalau ada macam ni, berita lebih terperinci lah. Dia bukan setakat gambar je, tu boleh tengok. Dia pun nak konteks detail pun boleh boleh masukkan kat situ lah. So, saya rasa belum ada lagi kot. Kan di Malaysia lah. Tu dah ada. Itu mungkin biasa dia. Kita rasa tak biasa. Ya. Ya, sebab dah pun dah printer pun kurang untuk pilihan. Inilah. Ni apa cetak? Malah berita lebih imersif. Yang ni sebab wartawan ni dia adalah content provider. Dia yang pergi kalau tempat peperangan tu bukan influencer boleh pergi tempat peperangan. Dia yang boleh pergi. So, macam mana dia nak bagi feel tapi dia dapat content. Dia ambil gambar ke, setakat share gambar mungkin tak dapat feel lagi. Share video pun mungkin tak dapat feel lagi. So, apa yang dibuat oleh New York Times ni, ibat satu 360 video. Ya, 360 video ni. Video YouTube lah. Okay, saya boleh pusing. Kalau boleh tengok sekeliling. 360. Boleh feel kita berada di sini. Kalau kita pakai kamera tu, seolah-olah kita berada di dalam kawasan tu. Yang dibuat ni dia memang nak bagi orang rasa macam mana keadaan orang susah lah, orang dekat pemerintahan, tak dapat pergi lah. Semua gambar saya tak dapat pergi. Tak nak pergi pun mana. Tolong. Dia tak fit sangat kalau bagi tengok video ni. Tapi kalau kita pakai kamera tu, kalau pergi kat besar nanti, memang dapat feel. Kita pakai tu memang kita rasa tu. Kadang-kadang kita pun tak sedar kita berada di alam maya. Sebab dia memang kita tengok kiri kanan, memang itulah. Memang ada. Cuma dia nampak di mata kita lah, kita buka dia sedar. Jadi kalau kita guna betul-betul alat dia tu, memang kita akan dapat lah imersif tu. Imersif tu maksudnya seolah-olah kita berada di situ lah. So inilah konten-konten yang mungkin ada privilege lah pada wartawan yang berada di tempat tu. Dia senang je lah ni record video tapi guna video yang 360 tu. Dia upload je kan, semua boleh rasa lah. Okay, kemudian mungkin juga kita boleh buat ini yang live dekat TV ni. So dekat TV keluar scan contohnya bernama bagi satu AR application, boleh je scan kat sini. Kat TV lah, orang tengok TV. Ada pun scan kat TV tu, keluar di senarai berita. Nak tengok Abang Bas ke, Maha 24 ke, GISB Chase ke. Oh, tak perlu tunggu ni, klik kat sini, keluar video tu. Ada kat TV tu. Jadi lebih personalized, sebab mungkin orang tak minat Abang Bas ni, orang minat GISB Chase ni, nak lagi tengok berita kan. Dia klik lah terus kat sini, dia personalized untuk dia. Scan je dekat TV tu. Dia orang akan tengok penambah sebab dia ada AR kan. Lepas tu buatlah bila scan dapat point. Promosi lah tu contoh lah. Azura bawah scroll dia. Baik. Dan ni nampak dah ada guna macam RTM sendiri. Dia dah ada guna AR ni. Maksudnya environment tadi studio. Dan dia masukkan ni lah animasi ni kan. Cuma ni tak ni biasalah, biasa bagi video editing kan. Yang ni yang buat yang menarik. Tengok ini.
We're after the storm. The roads have been cleared. We're ready to get back out on the roads. Let's bring this car out actually into augmented reality and show you what I'm talking about. Because you hit the roads are clear. Visibility looks great, right? You think there's no problem, but then you get behind this guy. You know, the one that doesn't clear the snow and the ice off of their roof. Well, all of a sudden, you've got little bits of snow and ice streaming off of the top of the vehicle. That affects your visibility. With this recent snowstorm, we got anywhere from, 6 inches to 10 inches to even 20 inches of snow and ice. And if you didn't clean off your car properly, now you've got slabs of snow and ice on top of the car. It's an unstable situation, right? That snow came down yesterday. There's actually a little bit of ice on the bottom layer. And as you're driving, the air pushing forward against that knocks it off. And you've got this big slab of snow and ice basically just hurling through the air about to hit your vehicle. You know, you have to act fast. This is going to happen fast and you almost feel like it's working in slow motion though. This is 4 feet by 4 inches, it's 100 pounds, and it hits your vehicle with 10 tons of force. I mean, look what happened. Your vehicle windshield is smashed. This is a very dangerous situation, and you know, even little bits can break off and hit other vehicles. You need to pull over to the side of the road, put on your flashers, and then call for help. In a case like this, I think the real lesson learned here is, though, clean off your car ahead of time, right? Make sure you're not one of the ones leaving that big snow of a slab on top of your vehicle, and stay safe for the rest of this winter. So these guys on this road here, West End Avenue in New York City, you know what your first order business is? Clear those layers of snow and ice off the roof.
Ya, supaya akan berita kita macam tu kan, orang boleh imagine dan boleh faham lah kan. Nama ni kita cakap, susah lah nak faham. Ini adalah benda-benda yang kita boleh gunakan untuk jadikan berita kita tu bukan setakat sampai tapi difahami dan mesej tu bermanfaat.
Look at this car. Look at this car. You know, we're after the storm. The roads have been cleared. We're ready to get back out on the roads. Let's bring this car out, actually.
Ini dia, okay. Interaktif dan keterlibatan pengguna dalam berita. Kita nak dapatkan feedback daripada pengguna tu. Biasa kalau macam ni, dia buat letak dekat YouTube, ada orang boleh bagi feedback kat tepi tu kan. Tapi apa problem ni? Dia tak boleh nak kontrol dan orang public boleh nampak kan. Dan kita pun tak boleh nak analyze standar tu sebab dia adalah sistem orang. Eh, kita guna YouTube kan? Kalau kita guna sistem kita, mungkin lah. Ha, so, kalau nak buat jadi kita boleh buat kat sini, dia scan je QR code ni. Dekat apps kita ada ni lah. Sama ada dia mungkin kata, oh, tak betul tu, pemberita tu kata macam tu. Ha, dia pun ni submit maklum-maklum, dia tahu ya sebenarnya macam ni, macam ni, macam ni. Ha, so, dekat software kita tu, link tu, tu dia ada letak sama ada kena ada verification ke, nombor telefon yang betul ke. Ha, dan contohnya bila next time orang lain scan berita sama, dia scan dia nampak ada ralat fakta. Dia klik kat sini, boleh dia beritahu apa yang tersilap tu. Mungkin pemberita dah betul kan. So berita tu dia tak betul kan, dia betul kan dekat AR kita tu. Kan? Ha, tu kita nak wujudkan interaktif dan kita nak libatkan netizen lah. Netizen yang beretika kadang-kadang kita uji berita lah, memastikan berita kita tu tepat, benar dan bukan palsu ataupun tersilap. Okay, ini kalau kita guna ni untuk wartawan lebih mudah, terutamanya kalau datang dengan nak beli kepuk lekor siar ke, siar tu macam mana, guna alat ni boleh membantu lah senang nak beli kepuk. Sebut kepuk longsor ke, kepuk boleh faham lah, jangan cakap. Tengok sikit. Bukan wartawan je lah, semua orang.
Design in a way that is built for the real world and doesn't take you away from it. And AR gives us new ways to accomplish this. Let's take language as an example. Language is just so fundamental to connecting with one another. Yet, understanding someone who speaks a different language or trying to follow a conversation if you're deaf or hard of hearing can be a real challenge. Let's see what happens when we take our advancements in translation and transcription and deliver them in your line of sight in one of the early prototypes we've been testing. Take a look.
My mother speaks Mandarin, and I speak English, which is a strange thing.
他讲英文我可以听得懂, 可是有时候我讲不来嘛。
We'd love to be able to share with you a new prototype we've been working on. You should be seeing what I'm saying just transcribed for you in real time, kind of like subtitles for the world.
What we're working on is technology that enables us to break down language barriers, taking years of research in Google Translate and bringing that to glasses.
You see me?
Oh, sí, sí te veo.
Oh, I'm actually looking straight into your eyes, and it seems like you're looking right at me.
Oh, sí, sí, estoy viendo lo que estás diciendo para ayudarte.
Making access to information just instant and intuitive. By doing that, technology fades into the background, and we're more connected with the people and the things around us. Giving people the gift of communicating with anyone, no matter what language they speak, I think is a really powerful thing.
Que tengo que dialogar con muchas personas que solamente hablan inglés. Como magia para mí, porque voy a ver cosas que voy a entender lo que ellos dicen por completo y
ya se puede 互相沟通. 我爱你.
You can see it in their face.
Sekali. Boleh guna AR untuk buat training. Ini sebagai contoh, kita tunjuk satu sampel rekod ni buat untuk training dia.
What if there was a way for employees to work together from anywhere when everything is on the line? Employees are the heart of every business. It's their resourcefulness, ingenuity, and drive that get the job done. But even the best employees need help from people who aren't there with them. Now employees on site can work side by side with experts in remote locations. In an instant, they can share what they see, lend a helping hand, walk through the process step by step, helping solve problems in real time. This is a new vision for work. Now employees can work smarter and bring in the people they need with just a tap. They can troubleshoot, repair, and perform with confidence and speed. They can move freely, pull critical information into view, and stay focused on the task, their hands free to do the work. This is collaborative problem solving at full speed. Your people, united across time and distance, more connected, more informed, and more efficient. Now employees can work together from anywhere. They can go there without being there. This isn't the future. This is here and now.
Alat ni memang ada di MIK, saya dah makan. Tapi saya pakai dalam lab dia, saya pakai kat luar. Sebab bila kita pakai tu, kita nampak skrin tu. Kalau kita guna Google Meet kan, dia keluar kat skrin. Skrin komputer tu nampak di depan tu. Orang depan pun kita nampak. Dan kita lihat sikit, tekan-tekan je ni. Bahaya sikit. Jadi tu tekan skrin tu. Jangan nak try tu, bolehlah tentang MIK di Bersama. So, itu sahaja untuk sesi perkongsian berkaitan dengan AR pada sesi hands-on lepas ni. Kita lihat dulu ke acara? Deep break.